in the first reading from the prophet Isaiah, he said, "Open up the gates to a nation." The Lord has opened up those gates. When he died, he washed away our sins with his death. He rose, he defeated death by his resurrection. And then he went down to gather the souls of all the just who were in a waiting place because the gates of heaven were closed since the sin of Adam and Eve. And he took them with him up to heaven and opened the gates. And we who have been baptized are privileged to respond to God's grace throughout the rest of our lives and let his grace continue to work in us, to help us to live holy and faithful lives. In the common of the Mass, we pray, "Stir up your power, O Lord, and come to our help with your mighty power, with your mighty strength, that what our sins impede, what our sins try to slow down or lessen or prevent from entering, the grace of your mercy may face it. So when we in our human weakness sin, turn away from God, God's grace strengthens us and helps us." It reminds me of the phrase from St. Paul where he said, "Where sin abounds, grace abounds all the more." We are called to live that in our daily lives, to remember that we are members of his family, called to be faithful to him. And that is for all who are baptized. We are called to live out our baptismal promises. And we do that for our children, our grandchildren, by helping them to know when they were baptized, know what happened to them. But even in our own lives, to get that out. A number of months ago, we ran across a little story by Nikki Lumley, the Alpha program. Nikki tells this very interesting and beautiful story. He said a young police officer was taking his final exams at the London Police College. And the first three questions were relatively easy, and then he got to question number four. Question number four went like this: "You are on patrol in outer London when an explosion occurs in a gas main in a nearby street. On investigation, you find a large hole has been blown in the footpath, and there is an overturned van lying inside the van. There is a strong smell of alcohol. Both occupants, man and a woman, are injured. You recognize the woman as the wife of your divisional inspector, who is at present away in the United States. A passing motorist stops to offer you assistance, and you recognize that he is a man who is wonderful and drunk. Suddenly, another man runs out of a nearby house, shouting that his wife is expecting a baby, and the shock of the explosion has made the bird hit. Another man is crying for help, having been blown into an adjacent canal by the explosion, and he cannot swim. Bearing in mind the provisions of the Mental Health Act, describe in a few words what action you would take." The officer thought for a moment and picked up his pen and wrote, "I would take off my uniform and mingle with the crowd." That's the temptation, to take off our Christian uniform and to mingle with the crowd, to just do what everybody else is doing. It's so much easier. But we are called to remain distinct, to remember that we are baptized. We are members of God's family through baptism. We're called to live that out. And as we come to Mass, and as we have our intentions for the Mass, just going to open up your heart and mind and say, God, I'm going to go to God and say, God, I'm going to open up your gift and say, God, I'm going to go to God. But you, being the good friend that you are, turn to me and say, Father, give me your help. And we'll join in with your gift. And you're going to write out a check for $1,001, and we'll both sign the card, and we'll send it to our friend as a gift from both of us. I have still given my daughter, you have still given her $1,000, but my gift has seemed to have grown, because it's been joy with your gift. Now the priest, when he was telling us this, went on to explain, put that into perspective what we come to Mass. Because what we are doing is we're reflecting that Jesus is fully God, but he's also fully man, like us in all things except for sin. And Jesus at the Mass offers the sacrifice at the Mass, and Jesus is, his prayer is perfect prayer. His love is perfect prayer. His devotion is perfect devotion. His obedience is perfect obedience. But my prayer is not perfect prayer. My obedience is not perfect. My devotion is not perfect. But Jesus says to me and says to you, give me your prayer. Give me your devotion. Give me your obedience. Join in with my prayer. Join in with my obedience. Join in with my devotion. And we'll offer it to the Father as a gift from both of us. And that's what takes place in the Mass. We join all our prayers, all our sufferings, all our sacrifices with the prayer of Jesus, with the prayer of the Holy Spirit, and offer it to God the Father, asking Him in His grace to help us to remember who we are, adopted sons and daughters of the Father, brothers and sisters in Jesus, temples of the Holy Spirit, and to live as we are Christians, and to go out into the world and